Hello friends, today's video is on the heterotrophic nutrition in plants. As we all know that green plants are capable of synthesizing their organic food from simple inorganic materials like carbon dioxide, water and minerals through the process of photosynthesis. Such plants are called as autotrophs. But there are some other plants which are not capable of synthesizing their own organic food and depend upon some other external sources fully or partially for nutrition. Such plants are called as heterotrophs. So on the basis of nutrition, plants are categorized as autotrophs and heterotrophs. And heterotrophs are further categorized into four groups on the basis of sources from which they get their nutrition. And the groups are saprophytes, parasites, symbiotic and insectivores. First of all, saprophytes. Saprophytes are the organisms that grow on dead and decaying organic matters. They secrete extracellular enzymes to break down the complex compounds into simpler ones. It means carbohydrate breakdown into sugars, protein into amino acids, and fats into fatty acids. Most of them are bacteria and fungi. The spores of bacteria and fungi land on the surface of the organic material. They grow there and flourish and ultimately result in the degradation of the organic matter. Most common example of the saprophytes are the bread molds. You might have seen the cottony white to brown patches on the stale bread. These patches are the bread molds or the bread fungus. Most common examples of these bread molds are the rhizophus, penicillium and cladosporium. Now examples of saprophytic plants. Only one saprophytic angiospermic plant is known, named as Volsclegilia avila. This plant is also called as the humus plant because it is capable of absorbing the nutrients directly from the dead organic matter. Whereas other plants depend upon fungus for their nutritional requirement. Example is the Monotropa. Monotropa has mycorrhizal roots. It means roots are surrounded by dense fungal sheath from which hyphae spread into the soil. Individual hyphae penetrate into the cortical cells and form a connection called as fungal peg or peg connection. These fungal pegs are not directly connected with the plant cells, but they make the connection through a permeable sac called as the membranous sac. The cells of these fungal hyphae produce the enzymes which break down the complex organic materials into the simpler ones and transfer them to the plant cell through these permeable sacs. Such type of nutrition in which the plant utilizes fungal hyphae to draw its nutrients from the dead or living organism is called as mycotrophy. So in addition to dead organic matter, Monotropa plant also draws its nutrient through the fungus from nearby phototropic plants also. In that situation, this plant acts as the epiparasite. It means it is growing on the fungus, which is a parasite of the other living plant. So in that case, this Monotropa can't be called as the true humus plant or true saprophytic plant. The second category of the heterotrophic plant is the parasites. Parasites plant grow and obtain their organic food from the living organism called host. There are two types of parasitic plants, obligate and facultative. Obligate parasites grow only on the living host, whereas the facultative parasites are basically the saprophytes, but they can grow as parasites also. So on the basis of host, the parasites are categorized as stem parasites and root parasites. And these two categories are further categorized as holoparasite and semiparasites. First of all, stem parasites. As stated earlier, stem parasites can be holoparasites and semiparasites. Holoparasites are the plants which get their total food, that is organic food, water and minerals from host stem. Example is Cuscuta plant. The Cuscuta plant are very long, pale yellow, branched, achlorophyllous and without roots. Seeds of Cuscuta plant germinate in the soil. They grow in size and undergo rotatory movement, because of which they coil around the host stem. If the host stem is not available, young plant dies. And once the connection is established, the parasitic plant develop modified adventitious roots named as Haustoria, as shown in the picture. Vascular tissue of parasitic plant makes a contact with the vascular tissue of the host plant through these haustoria and start absorbing organic food, water and minerals. Once the parasitic plant start absorbing the total food from the host stem, it loses the connection from the soil and becomes completely dependent on the host plant. And the other type of the stem parasite is the semi-parasite. These plants are green because of presence of chlorophyll. It means these plants can synthesize the organic food themselves, but they depend upon host stem for the water and minerals. Example is the Viscum album. This plant parasitizes on the number of shrubs and trees, and here also shoots of parasitic plant is attached to the host by means of haustoria. The primary haustoria reaches up to the cortex of the host, and this primary haustoria gives rise to the secondary haustoria, which makes the contact with the xylem of the host plant and start absorbing the water and minerals. Other type of plant parasites are the root parasites, like stem parasites. They are also categorized as holoparasites and semi-parasites. Holoparasitic plants totally depend upon their nutritional requirement on roots of host plant. Example is Balanotropa. These plants are achlorophyllous and mostly colored. They have mycorrhizal roots which draw nutrients from the roots of host plant. And the working of mycorrhizal root is same as described in the saprophytic section. Other type of parasite is the semi-parasites. These plants depend partially on the host root for their nutritional requirements. Example is Centellum album. This plant is chlorophyllous. It means it can synthesize its organic food through the process of photosynthesis, but depends upon the roots of other plants for water and mineral supply. Young seedlings of central wood plant can grow independently up to an year, but not beyond that. Within this period, some plants develop the parasitic roots, that is haustoria, which makes a connection with the roots of nearby trees for their water and mineral supply. Third type of heterotrophic nutrition in plants is the symbiotic association. Interaction between two different biological organisms is called as symbiosis, and the plants involved in symbiosis are called as the symbionts. In this association, both the symbionts are mutually benefited. First example is mycorrhiza. It is the association of fungus with the roots of higher plants. In mycorrhiza, fungus provide protection, water and mineral supply to plant, and in return, roots of higher plant provide shelter and carbon source to the fungus. Mycorrhiza can be of two types, ectotropic mycorrhiza and endotropic mycorrhiza. In ectotropic mycorrhiza, fungal hyphae may remain in the intracellular spaces, and some of these hyphae develop haustoria and penetrate the cells of host to obtain the nutrients. Such type of mycorrhiza is called as endotropic mycorrhiza. Ectotropic mycorrhiza is found in pinus, and endotropic mycorrhiza is found in walnut plant. Second example is the lichen. It is the association of algae with a fungus. In this case also, algae provide shelter and food to the fungus, and in return, fungus provide protection, water and mineral supply to the algae. You might have seen lichens as large crusty leaf-like patches on the rocks and the walls of old buildings and also on the trees. You can see the picture for reference. Third type of symbiotic association is the association of leguminous plants with a nitrogen-fixing bacteria, mainly rhizobium. First of all, formation of root nodule. Leguminous plants released organic compounds from their roots into the soil. These compounds attract rhizobia towards them and also activate the knot gene in bacteria to produce knot factor. Knot factor initiate curling of root around rhizobia and forms an opening called infection thread through which bacteria enters the root cells. This curling of root hair continues until the sufficient amount of bacteria are captured. During this process, various biochemical and morphological changes happen in the root. These changes trigger the cell division in root cortex. Bacteria also divide multiple times and form microcolonies. These microcolonies enter the developing nodule through the infection threads. Cells of newly formed nodule proliferate out of the root epidermis and form small bulgings called root nodule at the root surface. Vascular tissue also develops in the root nodule, which makes connection with the vascular tissue of root. These nodules are visible with the naked eye in 4 to 5 week old legume plant. So this was the whole process of nodule formation in short. In these nodules, nitrogen is fixed by bacteria. In the process of nitrogen fixation, nitrogen is converted by bacteria into ammonia with the help of nitrogenase enzyme produced by plant, which is then assimilated into amino acids, which are the building blocks of various kinds of proteins, and into the nucleotides, which are the building blocks of DNA, RNA, and ATP. In this association, bacteria gets shelter and organic acid in return. After plant dies, nodules rupture and bacteria becomes free to infect new host. And surplus amount of nitrogen is utilized by neighboring plants. Fourth type of heterotrophic plants are the insectivorous plants. These plants eat up the insects, as the name suggests. That is why they are also called as the carnivorous plants. The most common example of insectivorous plant is the Nepenthes, also called as the pitcher plant. These plants are climbers, bearing long modified leaves. In the modification of leaves, leaf base becomes flat and foliaceous. Petiole of the leaf becomes elongated and tendriler. Lamina of the leaf becomes pitcher, and leaf apex becomes lid of the pitcher, which protects the pitcher from rainfall. Now, the structure of the pitcher. Rim of the pitcher bears nectar glands, which continue up to the neck region. Just below these glands, there is a waxy, slippery surface. This surface also bears backwardly pointed hair and scales. Pitcher also bears digestive glands in the lower half region of the wall. The secretion of these digestive glands fill the bottom of the pitcher. As the insect visits the pitcher for the nectar, it slips down and fell into the digestive fluid. It cannot come out due to the presence of the backwardly pointed hair. The insect proteins are digested by the proteinase enzyme present in the fluid into the amino acids, which are absorbed by the plant. And remains of insects are further digested by the microorganisms present in the fluid. Other examples of insectivorous plants are the sundew and Venus flytrap. So that was all about the heterotrophic nutrition plants.